In this video, we are looking at combination PPE to protect us against some of the more common things that we're going to see in the hospital, such as influenza. It is influenza season at the time of this recording, and so we need to make sure we're wearing our contact and droplet precautions. But we're going to talk about all of that right after this. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Now before we get started, I do want to take a little bit of a moment to do a public service announcement, or a rant as they're sometimes known. I have recently had to explain to people who work in the healthcare field that PPE is there to protect not just them, but the other people that they are serving. So for example, there was a family member visiting her mom who was in with influenza A in isolation, confirmed diagnosis. And this family member was sitting there in gown and gloves only. And when I went to educate them, without knowing she was healthcare, explained to her the rationale and the PPE that she was missing and provided it to her, the response was, "I'm in healthcare, I know what I'm doing." You don't know what you're doing. You need to make sure you're not just centered on yourself. You have to protect the others that you're going to come in contact with. So please, these are not just guidelines or suggestions. These are, in fact, the pieces of equipment you need to take care of yourself and those that you care for. PSA done. Now we can go on to contact and droplet precautions. Combination. So in our previous videos, we talked about droplet precautions on their own, and droplets are those larger particles that don't travel as far, and we need to be close up in order to be in a range of which we are at risk. So we just use our surgical mask for that. And in contact precautions, those are the ones that we get with skin-to-skin contact or by touching their environment. So now we're going to put those two together. These patients can still have their door open because, again, remember the droplets don't travel 15 meters, they're traveling 2, 3, and 4 meters in duration. If we need to put our patients together in a room, we've got more than one, we need to at least put 2 meters between those patients to help decrease the risk of transmitting that microorganism. Some of our common things are influenza. That is such a big thing right now in our hospitals. This is currently January when I'm filming this video, so this is a big time for influenza. Another one is RSV. We see that commonly in infants. Norovirus, rhinovirus, enterovirus. There is a list. What's important to know, though, is you want to be looking at your document in your facility to identify that the patient's diagnosis matches the contact precautions that you are employing to protect yourself and others. Now, in my facility, when we do have an influenza patient, there is a special note on here, and I don't know if everybody notices it because it's on the back side of our document. So there's our front side, and everybody sees what we need to wear, but on the back side it says specifically if you're aerosolizing any medication, so you're doing some Ventolin aerosolization, we need to wear an N95 mask, because we're now aerosolizing and we have those smaller particles in the air, which puts us at risk. So please make sure you're always reading front and back. And now let's head on to our demo of donning and doffing our contact and droplet precautions. Now we're going to get ready as if we're going into a room that requires contact and droplet precautions. So we're going to start with our gown. Finding those top straps and doing those up at the back. And taking these ones, I want to ensure I'm covered at the back to protect myself and my patients. Next is the surgical mask. This is followed by our face mask. Last, we have our gloves. Now let's look at the doffing procedure.
Beginning with your gloves, we're going to turn them inside each other and discard these. We want to get rid of the gloves first so we can wash our hands and then remove our other pieces of equipment with clean hands, reducing the risk of transmission of those microorganisms. Moving on to your gown, we're going to be careful to try and only touch the ties, undoing those gowns, and then we're going to grab the inside shoulder if possible, wrapping that down over your arms and discarding your gown. Now, of course, you probably guessed it, we're going to complete hand hygiene because our hands may have been contaminated in that process. Next, we're going to remove our face shield, complete hand hygiene, and then remove our surgical mask, making sure we finish off with that hand hygiene so that we can move on to our next patient.
So remember, for your NCLEX exam, if those of you watching are still waiting to write, this may be information you need to match up diagnosis with PPE. So this is a good review for you, and for those who are in healthcare who know what they're doing, this is also a good review so that you can educate those around you and elevate your practice. Until next time, make it a great day.